Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests and supporters, distinguished participants, but first of all, friends, welcome to the 23rd Navigator Assembly. It is with great pleasure and honor that I extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you gathered here today, representing the very heart of the Greek maritime cluster. As we gather around the table, we embark on a journey of dialogue, collaboration, and collective vision. Before doing so, I would like to go ahead a little bit with a few more details. In the dynamic realm of shipping, it is crucial that we engage in honest conversations about the current realities and future challenges of life ahead, that lie ahead. The seas are vast, but our resolve is even greater. Together, we possess the power to shape the course of our industry, to navigate through turbulent waters, and to emerge stronger and more resilient than ever before. Today, as we gather amidst constant geopolitical challenges and global uncertainties, our purpose becomes even more profound. We must not only address the pressing issues of our time, but also strive to pioneer solutions that will redefine the landscape of shipping for generations to come. Greece has long held the primary position in the shipping arena, and it is our duty, our privilege, to uphold this legacy and serve as an inspiration for future generations. Let us not merely adapt to change, but let us be the architects of change. Let us forge new pathways, break barriers, and set sail towards a brighter, more sustainable future. It is a pleasure to welcome both familiar faces and new members to our Navigator family of more than 33 years. Here is a snapshot of our journey. Navigator Shipping Consultants exclusively represents a significant number of globally renowned towing companies and shipping agencies operating in over 1,400 commercial ports worldwide with a fleet of more than 1,000 tugs. Our mission is to foster excellent relationships within the Greek shipping community, ensuring high-quality service and economic benefits for shipping companies, where towage costs constitute, in many ports, the largest part of the berthing expenses. We have recently expanded our partnerships and strengthened our global presence in Latin America with Ultramar Group, representing 5 new countries: Chile, Colombia, Brazil, Peru, and Ecuador, as well as prominent shipping services in the United Arab Emirates. Navigator, the Shipping Decision Makers Forum, has been an annual gathering since 2001. And for 23 consecutive years, we have remained committed to nurturing and promoting this dialogue. And last year alone, we welcomed almost 1,000 executives from the entire spectrum of the shipping community. Reflecting on the discussions and achievements of the 22nd Navigator 2023, the Shipping Decision Makers Forum were reminded of the pivotal points that have shaped our industry. The acknowledgement of seafarers as the backbone of our industry, the insights from experts on market dynamics and sustainability, and the exploration of future outlooks, including advancements in technology and regulatory changes, all underscore the resilience and adaptability of the Greek shipping industry. As we acknowledge these milestones and insights, it's crucial to recognize the progression of the Navigator Assembly over the years. From its inception in 2001, where we discussed the future of shipping, ship agency and towage, to the creation of ambassador panels in 2012, and the establishment of the Navigator Advisory Board in 2018, each milestone has contributed to our collective growth and evolution. This year, we have reached another significant milestone by inviting 250 individuals from 165 ship-owning and ship-service companies to participate in roundtable discussions covering 5 thematic topics: decarbonization, human element, smart shipping, ESG, environmental, social, and governance, and maritime supply chain. Your presence today shows dedication to tangible results in our industry. Thank you for joining us amidst your busy schedules, and let us not just discuss, but commit to actionable steps that drive progress and shape the future trajectory in the Greek maritime cluster. The outcomes of the assembly will be presented at the 23rd Navigator 2024, the Shipping Decision Makers Forum in Chios and in Ousos Islands from September 20th to 22nd, 2024. Our forum brings together industry leaders, policy makers, social partners, academia, regulators, and stakeholders to exchange viewpoints, share knowledge, and shape the future of maritime. Education and the integration of young people into shipping are paramount. Through this forum, we foster open dialogue between executives, students, and graduates, aiming to cultivate competent executives who will sustain our industry's excellence. We have made significant strides in this endeavor with physical, and I say again, physical presentations to 70 schools every year and over 10,000 students in the current academic year alone, all under the official approval of the Ministry of Education and Religious Affairs and the Institute of Educational Policy. Our efforts include initiatives like the first Youth Day of Posidonia, company visits since 2016, company visits for young people. Tomorrow we're having two open days in shipping companies with the participation of over 50 young people, and mentoring programs. We have already created 70 mentor-mentee pairs that university students are being mentored by people from the shipping community. And the specific outcomes will be presented at Posidonia on our 2016, 2018, 2022, at our fourth YES Forum. Additionally, a maritime guide will be published by the Optra on 5th May 2024, ensuring that both young and old can explore our industry's rich history and career opportunities. At this point, I would like to mention to you that there is no shipping fairy tale or guide or anything around blue economy in any Greek bookshop or library. So it's important. Library, I mean, that students of the elementary and high school can get in order to get to know what is shipping and the blue economy. In conclusion, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to each of you for your unwavering commitment, passion, and dedication to our shared mission. A special thanks to our moderators and international guests for enriching this event with your presence and expertise. Lastly, I express profound appreciation to our sponsors, because without them, we would not be here today. And let me mention them. ABB, ABC Maritime, Austria Card Holdings, Benefit, Cool Dynamic, Crosshold, Cygnus, DNV, Edit Automation, Ernst & Young, Embassy of Panama, Fortune Technologies, Franman, Golden Cargo, Hill Dickinson, IMEC, Inmartec, Katradis, Marikem Marigasis, Marine Traffic, Capler, M Maritime, Metropolitan College, Moor, Napa, Ocean King, Oriani, Palau International Ship Registry, Reach Global Europe, Ship Clyde Air Lubrication Systems, Sea Bright, Secavin, the American P&I Club, the Marshall Islands Registry, Port of Thessaloniki, Tototeo Maritime, UK P&I, and V-Ships. As we embark on this collective journey, let us remember that unity holds unmatched power. By joining forces, sharing insights, and embracing challenges, we have the capacity to shape a future where the Greek maritime cluster continues to thrive and flourish. Thank you once again for being part of this vital conversation, for being here to hashtag forge the future, and I eagerly anticipate the insights that will define this year's Navigator Forum. At this point, I would like to ask my father, Captain Dimitris, our president, to join the microphone, the stage, and say a few words as he's always doing.
Καλησπέρα σας. Θα είμαι πολύ σύντομος. Τα είπε όλα η Δανάη. Σας καλωσορίζω και εγώ στο σημερινό Assembly της Navigator. Αγαπητέ Πρόεδρε του Ναυτικού Επιμελητηρίου, Γιώργο Πατέρα, περιμένουμε να ακούσουμε με μεγάλο ενδιαφέρον τις απόψεις σου και τις θέσεις σου στα θέματα που απασχολούν τη σημερινή συνάντηση. Και ξέρουμε ότι η επιστημονική σου κατάρτιση θα δώσει καινούργιους δρόμους. Καλώς ήρθες. Να καλωσορίσω τον Αντιπρόεδρο του Ναυτικού Επιμελητηρίου, Γιώργο Αλεξανδράτο, και φίλο μου, που είναι η ψυχή και ο τόνος κάθε εκδήλωσης, διασκέδασης, γιατί λέει δύσκολες αλήθειες με τον δικό του όμως τρόπο. Αγαπητοί φίλοι, έχοντας υπηρετήσει την ναυτιλία από το 1965, το 65 είπα, σε όλες τις θέσεις του, ως δόκιμος πλοίαρχος και εφοπλιστής, νιώθω ιδιαίτερα περήφανος για τις επιτυχίες της ναυτιλιακής βιομηχανίας μας σε όλους τους τομείς. Επειδή στην Navigator συνεργαζόμαστε με πάρα πολλές εκατοντάδες στελέχη μεγάλων ναυτιλιακών εταιριών σε όλα τα μεγάλα λιμάνια της γης, για πάνω από 30 χρόνια, θέλω να σας διαβεβαιώσω ότι σχεδόν όλοι αυτοί αισθάνονται δέος και θαυμασμό για το ελληνικό ναυτιλιακό θαύμα. Και οπωσδήποτε, πολλές φορές μένουν με το στόμα ανοιχτό από τη διαχείριση που κάνουν οι decision makers και οι συνεργάτες τους στις ελληνικές ναυτιλιακές εταιρείες. Θα είμαι σύντομος για να ασχοληθείτε με τα σημαντικά θέματα του Assembly. Αλλά θα ήταν παράληψή μου να μην ευχαριστήσω τη Δανάη και τη Χριστίνα που πάνω από 20 χρόνια αντέχουν την γκρίνια μου. Γκρίνια του καπετάνιου, όπως τη λένε. Και να ευχαριστήσω και το team της Navigator που εργάζεται σκληρά κάθε ημέρα με μεγάλη επιτυχία. Επειδή ο θυμόσοφος λαός μας εντέλει με τη ρίση του τόπο στα νιάτα, εγώ πάντα πρόσθετα τόπο στα μορφωμένα, εκπαιδευμένα, δοκιμασμένα και με ήθος νιάτα, που παράλληλα με τις επιχειρηματικές δραστηριότητές τους οφείλουν να επιτελούν και κοινωνικό έργο. Όπως αφιλοκερδώς κάνει η Δανάη με τις επισκέψεις της στα σχολεία και πανεπιστήμια σε όλη τη χώρα για να ενημερώσει και να συνδέσει, για την ενημέρωση και τη σύνδεση μάλλον των μαθητών και φοιτητών μας με τις ναυτιλιακές επιχειρήσεις, αλλά και τις δεκάδες συναντήσεις όπως τη σημερινή. Τελειώνοντας, καλωσορίζω την κόρη μου Όλγα, που αφού τελείωσε την νομική Αθηνών και απέκτησε 3 μεταπτυχιακά με διακρίσεις στην Ελλάδα και το εξωτερικό, και αφού υπηρέτησε την νομική επιστήμη για 10 χρόνια στα μεγάλου κύρους νομικά γραφεία ποταμή της Βεκρής, επέλεξε, δεν ξέρω πώς θα βγει στο τέλος, από τον Απρίλιο να συμμετέχει στις δραστηριότητες της οικογένειας, στην ναυτιλία, ξενοδοχεία, ταξιδιωτικά γραφεία, real estate και όχι μόνο. Γιατί, όπως έχω ξαναπεί, οι συνέργειες και το hands-on φέρνουν τα σωστά αποτελέσματα σε όλα τα επίπεδα των επιχειρηματικών δραστηριοτήτων. Αγαπητοί συμμετέχοντες στο Assembly, σας ευχαριστώ για την παρουσία σας και εύχομαι καλή επιτυχία στα θέματα της σημερινής συνάντησης. Thank you all.
For the people that are not speaking Greek, Captain, he is in shipping since 1965, and he said that we have to empower the youth generation to respect each other, to love each other. He's loving us a lot. We are suffering from him. He's having four daughters. The three of them are with him, working with him and with our mother. And it's very important that we are all a family, because in shipping this is the magic thing, that we all feel a family. Okay, and this is why we also convinced our fourth sister not to go to the law, to come to shipping. So, at this point, I would like to ask to our president of the shipping chapter, Dr. George Pateras, to join the stage. But before him coming, I would say that he's always expressing his beliefs based on what he's believing and what he feels in his heart. He is from the great paradise in Ousis. Okay, there is no, it's the paradise. And he's always mentioning how important are the Greek sailors, the role of the women in Greek shipping, and of course that we must transfer our knowledge to new generations. He's always trying to do many things with his great board of directors and team, because he's a team worker. I would like to thank him once again for being with us and to invite him at the stage. Thank you very much.
Good evening and welcome to Navigator, Forge the Future. Firstly, I want to say συγχαρητήρια κατά Δημήτρη, πέντε γυναίκες στη ζωή σου. I'm impressed. Really, I'm impressed. Και γνωρίζω και τις τρεις και ξέρω πόσο γερός πρέπει να είσαι. Και εσύ λες πως γρινάζεις. Οκ, θα το δεχτούμε. Λοιπόν, Navigator, as always, has managed to capture the five main issues of shipping today: ESG, the supply chain, decarbonization, smart shipping, and the human element. We need too many days to go through all of them in detail, as I would like to, but I think you all have things to do in the next three or four days. But I want to add one additional one, and that is contribution. Συνεισφορά. Exactly what we are doing today. We are putting our contribution and putting our mark on the future. We are the market, ladies and gentlemen. We are the market. Here in Greece, the latest statistics show that we have over 5,000 ships and over 400 million tons of shipping. So since we are the market, it's our obligation to forge the future. I have a saying which I've been using recently: let science prevail and not political correctness. It's sad that we hear what we hear every day coming up with new ideas. Ammonia, for God's sake, people, ammonia. Let's not try to kill everybody. So we at the Chamber are doing a study at the moment where we're actually looking what is the size of the ocean-going fleet. Ipondoporo Naftilia. Because we have many competitors, the second, third, and fourth fleet sizes, that have many cabotage vessels, vessels that will never go out of into international waters and out of national waters. So we're doing a study with the University of Piraeus to remove these ships from the fleet of our competitors. The first study, or the initial figures, show that we are almost 30% of the world fleet. That increases our responsibility. It does not just increase our gravitas. It really does increase our responsibility. No one knows the market as well as we do, because it, as Mr. Xiradakis used to tell us, it's in our DNA. It is in our DNA. And here we're given a perfect platform with Navigator to sit down and forge the future, to discuss the problems and educate the politicians. So here we are now, we're going to do the educating. We're going to find out, we're going to discuss, we're going to brainstorm. And then all the serious decisions will be made in September in Agnousa and another small island next to it. I forget the name. Chios. But the major decisions will be made in Agnusa. This is our responsibility, and this is something that we must embrace. We must take it on. We have a responsibility to get it right. We have been getting the environmental issues wrong for years. We're getting it wrong. We took sulfur. Systematically, we've been removing sulfur from exhaust gas from the 80s, from the 70s. And this has only caused the elevation of the seawater temperatures, the ocean temperatures. We seem to get it wrong every time. Unleaded gas. We decided we didn't want leaded fuel because obviously we had to remove leaded. And then we went to unleaded fuel, which is just as bad. We created the largest carbon footprint known to man. And instead of our politicians saying to engine manufacturers and fuel manufacturers, solve the problem, they turn to us to solve the problems. So let's do that. Let's solve the problem and tell them how it should be done. Thank you very much.
Before mentioning you the program and start the discussions, I just want to tell you that for second time after 2022, we organized just before the start of the assembly a two-hour discussion with around 25 shipping organizations, 22 to be specific, and not only shipping organizations, I can say, but have to do with the blue economy. And there was a discussion that we had it for 2 hours, but many of us said that we would like to have 3 hours at least. And I'm very happy that although we're meeting most of us all the time, today we have listened and we have learned of new problems or solutions or let's say issues for shipping that we have never heard before. What we said is that unfortunately in Greece we're overanalyzing. Too much analysis brings paralysis. And this is why today we would like to have a little bit more results on the discussions. We would like to go in Chios and in Ousis with more results and proposals that every year we will press a little bit more in order to make it happen, because we can do it. We are the number one power in the world, and we have to keep it running. And unfortunately, we have to work a lot for this to happen. So what will happen now? 6. 6 to 7:30 or a quarter to 8, okay, we will steal a little bit more. We will be having the roundtable discussions. So you will meet, you will get to know everybody that you're having in your tables, and then you will analyze. The moderators are already having an agenda of what to discuss and how to run the discussion. Then we will be having the closing remarks that will be presented by the universities, by Vicky Apostolopoulou, the Business Development Executive School of Maritime Studies at Metropolitan College, Seraphim Kapros, Professor of University of the Aegean. Now, this is happening today, really. Είναι από τσιγάρο, it's a cigarette, ναι, from the room. Every time somebody is smoking, this is happening. Very nice. Δημήτριος Κουμπογιάννης, Associate Professor of the Department of Naval Architecture, School of Engineering, University of West Attica. Μανώλης Καβουσανός, Director of Master in International Shipping Finance and Management. Δημήτρης Λυρίδη, of the University of Economy. Very nice. I think this is a cigar, not a cigarette. Δημήτρης Λυρίδης, because it was from before also, Associate Professor at the National Technical University of Athens. And last but not least, always, as he's here and we're very happy, Angelos Batouvakis, Dean and Professor at the University of Piraeus. And we're also having Yannis Theotokas also from the University of Piraeus. Okay, let's hope that they're not doing it on purpose in order for me to stop and for you to start the discussions. So, once more, thank you. I would like to thank the YES Forum volunteers. You can come up in order to see who are the YES Forum volunteers. Yes, don't be shy. You are very handsome. So, all these young people, they are studying in the Greek universities, not all in shipping. And they will keep the notes, the minutes of the meeting, and then they will also participate in creating the agenda of the HEOS Forum. And last but not least, Evanthea just came in order to say that it will not stop. Ναι, cigarette, we know, but it's a cigar, not a cigarette. It's a little bit bigger, I think, but never mind. So I would like to thank, of course, first of all, because Evanthea is suffering a lot from the forum and from me, in the good way, she's not suffering. Evanthea, and of course, all the team, Marina, Argyri, Gina, Elena, Ellen. Okay, they keep doing it. Yeah, of course, it's the cigar. They are telling me to stop talking. And then we will be having the cocktail session. So thank you very, very much all for being here with us. Let's start discussing and let's hope that we will be having good results. Thank you very, very much for your time.